Hi guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to add custom horizontal pricing ribbons to your Elementor website. It's extremely easy to do because I've done all the hard work for you, so sit back, relax, hit that like and subscribe button and let's get into the video. Okay guys, the first thing you need to do is obviously customize your pricing table. So add all your titles, your colors, your prices, and your list items. It's important that you do this before you move on to the next step. I'm gonna leave mine just how it is, just for the purpose of this video. Once you've added all your pricing and your headings, the next thing we're going to do is cheat and take a screenshot of that section. All will be explained why we're doing it this way as we go through the video. Now you're gonna need to save this image and upload it to your WordPress media gallery. Now the image of our pricing table has been uploaded, we're going to head over to our Elementor page and we're going to drag in a HTML widget. Now that our widget's been added, we're going to paste in our HTML code that you can see on the screen. Now once that page loads, you can see there is an image of a pricing table and this is the image we took a screenshot of earlier on. Now you will need to add your own image URL here, so just highlight this bit of code and paste in your own. Now what we want to do is add the text that we want displayed on our ribbon. I've opted to leave it as by now, but this is where you need to add your own text. And if you want to make it a clickable link, then highlight the hash and enter in your own URL. Now we're going to add our CSS code. And you do that by clicking in the top left hand side and scrolling down to the bottom and clicking on custom CSS. You do need Elementor Pro to be able to use custom CSS. There is a link for that in the description below. Now you're going to have to go back over to my website and copy the CSS part of the code. Don't worry, I will label this clearly for you when you get to my website. Now you're going to have to go back into the image pricing table and paste in the CSS code at the bottom. As soon as that code has been added, the ribbon will get added to your HTML widget. As you can see, I've placed it so it sits above the image button. This means it's not just an image, it's actually a pricing table with a function. Now you're probably saying to yourself that you don't want a red ribbon, and don't worry, I'm not going to leave you with that. I'm going to show you now how to customize the ribbon itself. If you want to change the size of your pricing table, move down to the second part of the code here where it says header image. And as you can see, it says 310. You can make this as big or as small as you want. If I change the image size from 310 to 210, you'll see it's gotten a lot smaller. If you do make the image bigger or smaller, you will also need to increase the size of the ribbon. Now, if you want to change the color of the ribbon, all you need to do is go down into the code where it says background color and start typing in the new color you want. Now, if your ribbon is smaller than the actual image, you can make it bigger on the next line down. All you have to do is increase the width and make sure it fits around the size of the image. You can also change the padding and the margins in this section, but if you look further down in this block, you can see you can change the font size. It's currently set at 20, but you can increase it to 30. I'm gonna leave this set at 20, but I am gonna scroll down now and change the color of the tags on the actual ribbon itself. Now I'm gonna scroll down to the next block of our CSS code where it says ribbon before and ribbon after, and I'm gonna change where it says red to yellow. And this is changing the tags on the outside of our ribbon. As soon as we finish typing in the actual color we want, it will change automatically. And underneath it says box shadow. At the moment it's set at red, I'm gonna change this to white, and this is the actual shadow of our tags. Now this is only a small detail, but it does make a big difference when you're actually using it on the overall website. Now the next thing I'm going to show you how to change the color of is the actual triangles in between our 3D ribbon and our tags. Now if you don't know what I mean, it's this little triangle just in here. Now the first one I'm going to show you how to change is the one on the right hand side. If I highlight the word black and change this to red, you'll notice that there's a small red triangle on the right hand side of our ribbon. If I go up to the next block, it will say black again. If I highlight this and I change it to red, you'll see the one on the left hand side also changes to red. The final color I'm going to show you how to change is the color of our text on our button. And we can do that by going down to the bottom of our code where it says nav A. And within that code, it says color black. And we're going to change this as we have before to red. And as you'll see, our text has turned to red. By using Colorzilla, you can choose any color you want for your text or your ribbon on your page. All you need to do is copy the hash color at the bottom of the page. And wherever you want to use that color on your ribbon, you can just copy it and paste it in. Now the final thing I'm going to show you is how to change the text on your ribbon. And you do that by going into the content tab in the top left hand side. Where it says buy now, we're going to highlight this and start typing in the text we want to be displayed within our ribbon. And I'm simply going to type in here, find out more. Now we want to add the URL so when people click on our button, it sends them to another page on our site. And we can do that by looking in our code for the word href. And when we find that, we can see there's a small hash that follows it. If we put in our new URL, we can send our customers to that page. So for the purpose of this video, I am only going to be sending our customers who click on the button to Google. Once I've finished typing in the address, I'm going to preview our page, and you do that by clicking on the eye next to the publish button. Once our page loads, you'll see that our pricing table has loaded, and if we click on the button, it will send us to Google. Now you still might be wondering why I used an image instead of a pricing table within Elementor. And this is simple, because if we'd have used a HTML widget and we tried to wrap it around a pricing widget, it wouldn't have actually made a 3D effect. All that had happened is our ribbon would have sat on top of our pricing table. The way we have it now wraps around it and creates that 3D effect instead of sitting on top and looking wrong. Now that's it for this video. Remember, if you do want to be able to use CSS within Elementor, you do need Elementor Pro. If you haven't got Elementor Pro, there is a link at the top of the description. It is an affiliate link. It doesn't cost you any more to use, but it does give me a very small percentage of Elementor's profits if you choose to sign up. If you have found this video useful, please do hit that like and subscribe button. And if you've got any questions, come and hit me up in the comments box below or come and find me on social media. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.